Hi guys, welcome back to Blast Zone.
I know it's been a very long time, guys.
A lot has happened in my life, and I'm gonna give you a quick update on my life at the end of this video, but I just wanna say a quick thank you to everyone who still watches my videos. I still see you guys comment on my YouTube, like, come back, BZK, come back to streaming, do this, do that. I see you guys, and I really appreciate that you guys have not given up on me, and I'm sorry I haven't been posting, but I am back. Thank you so much for still watching my videos, guys, and staying subscribed to me. It's motivation drive. But before that, I have a very exciting mystery box that we got from Hasbro. Beyblade Burst Quad Drive. Hasbro is celebrating International Top Spinning Day on the 12th of 2022. I'm still the Blast Zone Kid, guys. Once a blader, always a blader. This is the day, guys, and we are gonna unbox this and see what's inside. So let's get into this. All right, so let's open this mystery box, guys. Wow, it's the new Interstellar Drop Battle Set. Well, it's not really new. I've seen it on other channels, but today I'm gonna put my own perspective on this set, guys. I'm gonna tell you if I think it's good and if it's worth the buy. And yeah, let's get into opening it. I have not opened a new Beyblade set in a long time. You know, I'm kind of excited. Let's get cracking. Here's what's in this box, guys. Devastate Evo Bellfire B7, four modes. It has Core Mode, Apex, Core Plus, and Apex Plus. And then we have Prominence Phoenix P7, has the same modes as Bellfire. And this stadium is two layers. It might be hard to see because when I first saw this, I was like, there's two layers in this. But that disc actually drops, or you can take it out and you can leave it back in. It's two different modes kind of for the stadium. So we're gonna try both modes out. We're gonna see which one we like better. All right, guys, I put the stadium together. Everything is set up. I have not seen a double layer stadium in a long time, but this one looks pretty cool. I'm really excited to test it out. Okay, so basically this is called the warp hole. The Beyblades come down, or they're launched here and they go down. And this is just a pocket. If you get knocked out there, you basically lose. Also, we have the disc here. It goes here if you want it to. And if you want to do double layers of the stadium, you could just take it out. Here's how you take it out, this triangle. You got to press it hard down right here. Take it out like that. There's also two modes for the discs. You could basically like reverse it and put it like that. All right, so for the first battle, we're gonna have the disc in, and then we're gonna try it reverse, and then we're gonna go down to the warp hole. So it's gonna be a basic battle for now. All right, so we have Evo Bellfire right here, and we have Prominence Phoenix. Two, one. All right, my money's on Phoenix, guys. You know what'd be cool? If like the disc just dropped, I wouldn't have to change it. That'd be cooler than me having to take it off. But Phoenix is still a regular Phoenix. You know, he's very slow. He doesn't like to move. 1-0. Phoenix takes it. Survivor finish. All right, next battle. 2-1. My hands have gotten bigger. It's harder to launch. I really hope Evo just beats him once. This is the last battle, then we're going to go into the next mode, guys. Phoenix takes it for the first mode. Now we're gonna change the disc. We're gonna reverse it. Okay. Put it on here. Next battle. All right, now we're doing it with the disc reversed. Let's do this. Oh! All right, so I'm guessing if they don't get in there as soon as they're launched, none of them are gonna get in the hole because it's kind of guarded. It seems to be working for Bellfire though. It's really hurting Phoenix. Oh. Phoenix takes it. Last battle with this reverse disc, then we're gonna go to the warp hole.
No!
Oh, he's in the hole! I don't know if he could be knocked out, but from the videos I've seen, he can't be knocked out. No, he got knocked out. I'm really hoping for a win for Bellfire. I think he can take it.
What is?
I'm gonna go with the tie on that one. It's a tie. He didn't lose. So, now, it's time to unleash the warp hole, guys. Get this. Let's do this. All right, so far, guys, I think these Beyblades aren't really that good together. Like, their chemistry isn't there. What I mean by chemistry is, like, when they're in battle, like, their hits aren't that, like, explosive. Like, they don't. When they hit each other, they don't move around a lot, and there's just not a lot of burst. It's time to unleash the warp hole. I don't know what's gonna happen here. I haven't done a double layer stadium in a while. Let's hope Bellfire can take back his win. 3, 2, 1. Alright, immediately down into... Oh! Got you! That was pretty cool. The stadium seems to come in handy for Bellfire. So, he took that win. Once we go in the pocket, you know, he's still going to be spinning, but technically that's a ring out finish, so Bellfire takes it next battle. Alright, last battle. Let's hope Bellfire wins it. That's what happens when you take time off, guys. All right, I gotta grip it tight. Different strategy from Bellfire. He doesn't want to go down there. Now if he goes down there, he's probably gonna lose. Oh no, no. Well, he for effort. You know, I like the spinning around strategy. It's very, very unique. I don't think it works. I think he needs to try something new. We're gonna do one last battle because I was disappointed in that one too. Let's get it. Oh, he's down in the whirlpool immediately. I think Bellfire has this. Phoenix looks a little weak. I've noticed when they go in the whirlpool, the attacks are more brutal. Bellfire takes it. That means it's 2-2. So they tied, you know, Beyblades are equal. All right, so my honest review on the Interstellar Drop battle set. I feel like we could have picked better Beyblades for this stadium, more active ones, like two attack types, not one like defense or stamina and an attack. I feel like two attacks would have been pretty cool. But other than that, I think it's a really cool set. I really like their idea on the disc and the whirlpool and the pockets. But you know what I was thinking, like for the pockets, if you guys like, I don't know if you guys play on tables or grounds, but I thought this was pretty cool. What if you did like that? Like if you went down there, it completely drops, real actual ring out. I was thinking about that. But I do recommend this set. I think it's pretty cool because, you know, I'm sure you guys, you Beybladers out there, have a lot of Beyblades and you could just use it in this stadium. Four Beyblades in this. Pretty dope. So I do recommend this set. But other than that, guys, that does conclude our Beyblade part of this video. Now I'm going to explain where I've been, what's going on with me. Alright. So, I'm 15, guys. I am a sophomore in high school. A lot has been going on. I'm in the tennis team right now. Varsity tennis team for my school. Getting better over time. Still not the best player. Also, I do have a girlfriend, guys. Pretty amazing girlfriend. Her name is Zoe. Pretty nice. I'm gonna show you guys a video right now. I proposed to her for homecoming. I would love to come back, guys. I wanna get everything like worked out. Like I wanna know what I should do for you guys. I didn't like taking a break off, but it's what I needed. And I hope you guys respect that. And I really love everyone that stick around, still watches me, still subscribes. I just really appreciate everything, so. And if you guys have any advice or comments you want me to do in the future, like regarding my YouTube, my content, what I post, please let me know what you guys would like me to see. Like, not Beyblade, a secondary option, you know? But tell me in the comments below, I'd really appreciate that. We still do this. Bye, guys. Have fun.